wonder what's going on in the debt today. Let me take a look.
Hey man, back door please. All right, thanks.
Guys, we have a problem. Hello? Guys, listen up. Hey everyone, we need a contingency plan. There's a storm coming, and we can't be outside for the campus march, so we need to come up with something right now.
We completely forgot about the storm front coming in. I've known about it for 2 weeks.
You've known about it for 2 weeks? Where have you been? Under a rock?
Well, as you can see here, we have a particularly strong cold front coming into the central Ohio region. You can trust me, because I'm going to be a weather officer.
If you're going to be a weather officer, I'm going to be a weather officer. And I've known about this for 2 months.
Okay, King, I need you to put some plans together.
Plans? I'm all out of those. Plans? Stuart, I don't know what he's talking about. I'm a fifth year. I'm practically cadre now. Right, sir?
Okay, Sam, can you help me out here? I really need a timeline.
Timeline? I'm not even halfway done with the cadet mentorship program.
Who's cadet mentorship? Is that one of the 100s?
You know, every time I come here, people are all like, oh, I'm so busy doing this or that, but really, I don't see it at all.
Well, we need to come up. Is that Lightning McQueen?
What? No. Contingency plan? I mean, shoot, we have to march around the debt like 300 times.
One sec. He's right.
You know, when I first met Dalton, honestly, the amount of spreadsheets was pretty concerning, but it turns out they're pretty helpful.
We're doomed.
Hey, just so you know, we got the French Fieldhouse for tomorrow, so you can scrap your contingency plan. We'll just execute in there. Any questions? Anybody need anything? Okay, I guess we'll see you tomorrow.
Maybe we did! Woo! Oh, woo! did it.
Hey guys, there's some food in the fridge. You guys eat that up. Bonzi?
Yes, sir.
Food in the fridge. Eat that up.
I'll be there.
And we have a DV coming tomorrow, so the place really looks nice. Keep it up, guys.
So, what about the people that you work with? What's the deal with them?
I work with some pretty interesting people.
Enter. Close the door, close the door.
Sir, I come here requesting a favor. We really, really need to be able to listen to our headphones during the FA. It's just, we just keep running laps around and around that track in the French Fieldhouse, and it's just unbearable. It would improve the GMC. We really, really need this favor.
That I cannot do. You come in here, and you call me sir. I was your mentor last semester. And I know that last week you had a flight morale event at Buffalo Wild Wings. You know I love the spicy wings.
You're right, Cadet Godfather. We should have invited you. All the other POC convinced me not to.
They are very convincing. Well, I know that you guys... I'll have your way.
No, we can't say guys anymore.
Oh, sorry. I know that you all have your way of doing things, and that's fine, but sometimes I just like to be involved. If you want a favor, you gotta give something back.
Please, Cadet Godfather, we'll do anything. We need this favor. We need to be able to listen to music.
All right. I will grant you this favor, but in return, you and all of your flight must meet me at Buffalo Wild Wings next week and sing me happy birthday in a choir.
It's done. We'll do it.
Then it's done.
Thank you so much, Cadet Godfather. This means so much to me.
My pleasure. My pleasure. I'm happy to...
What are you guys doing in here?
Sir... Just hanging out.
Oh, just a mentor meeting.
Yeah.
Just clean it up and get out of here, okay?
Some chocolate milk, a banana, or something.
All right, good morning, class. So this morning we're going to talk about conflict resolution. And we've got some videos that AATC has provided us, specifically documenting how not to do this, okay? So pay attention and you'll see some good stuff.
You wanted to see me, Major Baratheon?
I did. You come in.
Sir, I report.
Sit down. Do you know why you're here today, Captain?
If this is about the fight I had with Lieutenant Stark, that...
Hold on, stop.
No idea.
You got in a fight with another officer? We're going to talk about this later. For now, I want to talk about this police report I got from your behavior on leave last week.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Oh, boy is right. Apparently, you punched a security guard at a Taylor Swift concert.
He was keeping me away from her.
You're not allowed to assault people, Captain. You stole 6 chihuahuas from an animal shelter, and you were screaming at an IRS agent to get your money back.
You know that taxation is theft.
I don't care. Can I continue?
Yes, sir. You may continue.
You haven't volunteered for anything this year. You were late every day this week, and now you have 2 pending assault charges.
No, sir. I was not late on Tuesday.
Captain, you weren't here Tuesday.
But I wasn't late.
This is not the point. Look, you showed up at this shop so full of potential, and ever since your PCS to England got denied, you've just stopped caring. Now, we have no choice here, Captain. Your next OPR is going to be a referral.
No, sir, please, no, not a that.
Captain, stop. This is not your first warning. This is not the first time this has happened. You've had 4 LORs in the past quarter. You knew this was coming. Now, you can appeal this referral, but unfortunately, I know the wing commander is going to go along with it.
Very well, sir. I demand a referral by combat.
Come on in, Cadet Ralph French. Sorry, I forgot you got married.
It's okay. I actually changed it to Ralph French because people keep messing it up.
Yeah, go ahead and take a seat.
Zach and I are really excited about going to see Tops and Blues this weekend.
Well, that's great, but that's actually not why I called you in here. Unfortunately, I have to give you an Article 15 because you got too many speeding tickets on base.
What? That's ridiculous. Preposterous. That's absurd. We were supposed to be friends. You were supposed to cover for me. Ugh. And Tops and Blues doesn't even exist anymore.
Well, I don't think Sergeant Schaefer's going to want to go after I deny his PCS to Hawaii.
Come in, Major Kipnis. Don't bother with all that.
Okay, sir. What's this all about? I was just in a hurry to get home and feed my turtle. He hasn't eaten in days.
Major, are you familiar with the story of General Meade?
General Meade, I think he's in our chain of command, right?
General Meade was a great military commander for our side during the Civil War. He actually was one of the few generals to break Stonewall Jackson's wall at the Battle of Frederickson. He was actually woken up one morning by General Grant himself when he had to go on the battlefield in his own pajamas.
Really? In his own pajamas? Okay, why are you telling me this?
Oh, nothing. I just thought you would find it amusing. I went to take a trip last week into Gettysburg, and I thought it was pretty interesting.
I'm pretty sure none of this is real, so why are you telling me?
Anyway, the reason why I called you in here is because your performance has been pretty bad recently, so I'm going to have you fired.
Okay, so you think you can fire me without any paperwork?
Yeah, to tell you the truth, I didn't really feel like doing that this time. You know, being a full-grown colonel takes up a lot of time. I have a lot of obligations. I didn't have time for that.
Okay, so you know you can't do this, right?
Well, you can map that way out to your next job, because
okay.
The Air Force has no room for Cleveland Indian fans like you.
I thought you said this was about my reports.
Oh, yeah, that's what I meant to say, reports.
Okay, sir, you know what? I just want to say on record that this is ridiculous.
All right, class. So those are great examples of what not to do. Next, we're going to talk about, for the remainder of class, how you actually should be doing it.
We'll be right back.
find them.
I'm sure they're around here somewhere.
We just got our EAs. We gotta find the wisest people in the bed.
I bet Mr. G knows where they are.
Yeah, he knows everything.
We're gonna be pilots, guys!
Just go inside, Kenny.
So you guys aren't excited at all about being pilots? Like, not even a little bit?
We'll see. We'll see what happens. Good afternoon, Mr. G.
Hey, good afternoon.
Have you seen any of the fifth years?
Are you kidding me? I haven't seen them for years. I think they quit. Anyways, I was waiting for Cadet Optic. He was supposed to be up here. He did an extreme golf tournament about a month ago. Haven't seen him. Hello, yep. Yeah? Hey, hold on. Let me come down. I'll come down and get the door for you. Hold on. You guys have to see me a little bit later. Go get this door.
I'm sure we'll find him at some
point. I hope so.
I thought for sure Mr. G wouldn't know.
I know. They could literally be anywhere in the world right now.
Aw, I'm your guys' world?
No, behind you.
The map.
Oh.
Why do you still have them?
Yeah, go put it back.
Fine.
Trust your NCOs.
Did you guys hear that?
Yeah, what was that?
Rob, we're back.
Wait, what'd you say?
We're back.
No, before that.
Trust the NCO?
I got it, guys. Follow me.
We were all need to work on our cadet training.
You don't know where cadet training went, do you? He asked me to hold this gold paint. Something about putting it on.
Good lord, putting gold paint on.
Cool. No, I have no idea. I'm just sitting here trying to get this dang new version of Wings to stop acting up. I'm guessing they're calling it like X-Wings now? That's not much.
Afternoon, gentlemen.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, how are you?
Stand up.
So, we were just looking for the 800s. We really want to talk to them, and we heard that you guys are the most knowledgeable people in the dead. We were wondering if you know where they are.
Wait, who? I didn't even know we had 800s.
No.
I think I know who might.
Hey, sir. We have some cadets who might need your help.
I'll be right over there.
I've heard there's a problem. What can I help with?
Sir, these cadets were looking for 800s?
I don't know.
The 800s? I'm pretty sure we have a few of those. In fact, I've heard they've been doing some pretty good stuff. Come to think of it, though, I haven't seen them in a few months. If any of you all find them, can you let me know what they've been up to?
Absolutely, sir. Well, thanks anyway, gentlemen. I guess we'll keep looking?
Yeah.
What's the deal with this guy? Does he come with a detachment?
Been through the entire detachment, and nobody knows where they are.
There's got to be someone who knows where they are.
Hey guys, use this room?
Nah, come on in, Richard.
Hey, what's going on?
We're just looking for some people. Maybe you've seen them?
Oh, who are you looking for?
Two guys that look like brothers and one that looks like their tall, goofy cousin.
Yeah, I see them across the street. I see them all the time.
Oh, I know exactly where they are. Let's go. Thanks, Richard.
Sure, no problem.
You guys want to go in there?
No, not at all. I'm not risking my AA in somewhere like that.
Yeah, I hear all kinds of people in the galaxy go there.
So, what do you guys want to do now?
I don't know. I'm kind of hungry.
Let's go somewhere new. Let's go somewhere fresh. Panera.
That's not new or fresh. All right, fine.
Yeah, so that's how the cookie crumbles.
Dude, you're still not getting a bite of my cookie.
No cookie for you.
There you guys are.
I've been for you the whole time.
What do you mean? We've been here the whole time. We just got our EAs and we've been looking for some advice.
Well, we're usually here on the third floor. Nobody seems to know that we're even there.
So can we, like, sit down?
Yeah, sure, Pop Squad.
Whoa. $5 a seat.
Just sit down.
Yeah. That was beer money for next weekend.
So, what's up?
Well, we've been looking for advice, and that wasn't very helpful.
What do you mean? We've been there the whole time, and we trained with you last semester, and then this semester, the people that we trained are now training you.
Yeah, and I mean, if you think about it, essentially, we've trained every single person in this wing at some point, especially the POC. So, indirectly, we've trained them who have now trained you.
Oh, that does make sense.
But what have you guys been doing on the third floor the whole time?
Planning time now!
Well, that was interesting. Yeah, it's time for the gym.
Guys, we need a contingency plan. We're gonna be outside. We need something to do. Right now, the weather's bad. Guys, we need a contingency plan. There's a storm coming. The weather's. Hey everyone, we need a contingency plan.
I know King was laughing at me.
Hey everyone, we need pronounce my words now. Whew.
We need a contingency plan.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting Cal.
Interrupting
Moo.
Cal.
My pleasure. I'm happy to do it for you. Happy to do it for you.
Oh, who are you looking for?
Two guys that look like twins and one that looks like their older goofy brother. I got it, guys. Follow me.
I just followed him.
Yeah, you're supposed to go this way.
Anzio's are over there.
Yep, so that's how the cookie crumbles.
Dude, you're still not gonna bite.
There you guys are.
Yeah, we've been upstairs pretty much the whole
time. Very well, sir. I demand a referral by combat.
Wow.
You stole 6 chihuahuas from an animal shelter, and you were screaming at an IRS agent to get your money back.
You know that taxation is theft.
I don't care about your Ron Paul note.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Owls.
Owls who?
Yes, they do.